Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD.
Today I'm going to explain about rhizobium inoculant production and testing root nodule ability. Rhizobium is a gram-negative aerobic rod-shaped bacterium. It contains refractive granules. It is a soil bacterium present in large number in rhizosphere of legume roots. Different species of rhizobium can fix 50 to 100 kg nitrogen per hectare per year in leguminous crops. Therefore, they have been recommended as nitrogen biofertilizer in agriculture. It belongs to Rhizobiaceae family. Rhizobium are symbiotic diazotrophs. It forms an endosymbiotic association with legumes. They are non-spore forming bacteria. Classification of Rhizobium. Rhizobiaceae family have 5 important genera. Rhizobium, slow-growing rhizobia, produce acid. Bradyrhizobium, which is a fast-growing rhizobia, produce alkali. Azorhizobium, it inducing both stem and root nodules. Next is Cyanorhizobium and the final one is Photorhizobium. Now, how does this rhizobium helps in nitrogen fixation? First, the interaction between the rhizobium and the legume is by flavonoid produced and secreted by legume. Exopolysaccharides produced by rhizobium interact with lectin produced from the plant. Exopolysaccharides helps to bind rhizobium cells to the root hair. Rhizobium produce IAA. The curling of the root hair is attributed to IAA. Therefore, rhizobia become enclosed by the root hair wall. Root hair curling forms a structure called shepherd crook. The infectious thread originate from the tip of the curled portion of root hair seal. It is a tubular structure that carry rhizobia from the root surface to root cortex. The nucleus of the root hair cell guides the pathway of infectious thread to the root hair. Infectious thread continues to grow beyond the root hair cell and penetrate the cortex cell. On entering to the cortical cell, the infectious thread branches, rhizobia are released shortly into cortical cell. Concurrent with the invasion of rhizobia, there occurs a rapid burst of cell division of the host seal and rhizobia changes their shape to form a cell called bacterioids. The interaction is highly specific and result in nodule formation. Inside the nodule, many bacteria are present in bacterioidal form, which is an undivided stage, which produce nitrogenase enzyme. The enzyme reduces atmospheric nitrogen into ammonia. This process is called nitrogen fixation. The rhizobium species are host specific. Means one rhizobial species able to nodulate or infect a group of specific leguminous plant species and is called cross inoculation group. The species of rhizobium differ in their ability to fix nitrogen. Screening is essential to select the efficient nitrogen fixing species for preparation of biofertilizer. Next is rhizobium inoculant production. For that, first we have to collect the nodules. Fresh and healthy root nodules were selected from leguminous plant. The nodules were usually light brown or pinkish in color, which indicate that an active nitrogen fixation had been established between the nodule bacteria and the legume plant. Next is isolation of rhizobium. The root nodules are kept immersed in 0.1% potassium chloride solution and or in 0.1% acidified mercury chloride. The sterilized root nodules are then washed 5 to 6 times in distilled water. They are once again sterilized by immersing them in 90% ethyl alcohol for 10 seconds and washed repeatedly with distilled water. They were crushed to make suspension. Yeast mannitol agar plate are prepared and sterilized by autoclaving. Nodular extract is prepared by taking 1 gram of nodular extract into 10 ml of sterile distilled water and mixed well with to get a suspension. 1 ml of nodular extract suspension is diluted to 9 ml of sterile distilled water, making the dilution to 10 to the power of minus 2. Similarly, make the dilution up to 10 to the power of minus 8 are made separately for each nodule extract. Then 0.1 ml of nodular extract suspension from 10 to the power of minus 3 to minus 8 dilution are inoculated into sterile yeast mannitol agar plate. The samples are spread throughout the yeast mannitol plate. Next is colony characterization. In case of colony characterization, that is shape, size, color, opacity, elevation, edge, margin of bacterial colony and their growth rate were determined by observing the colony on yeast mannitol agar plate after growing at 30 degree centigrade. Microscopic observation of the isolates was done using Gram staining technique. Coming to culture and metabolic characterization, first test is Congo red test. The purity of the rhizobial isolates was detected by adding Congo red in yeast mannitol agar media because most rhizobia absorb the dye very less. Next test is growth on glucose peptone agar. Glucose peptone media was used to differentiate rhizobia, which usually grows or which usually shows little or no growth on medium without altering the pH of the media. Contaminants like agrobacterium shows massive growth on the medium with a distinct change in pH. Growth on 2% sodium chloride to the basal media of yeast mannitol agar, 2% sodium chloride was added to check the purity of the isolate, as 2% sodium chloride is inhibitory for most rhizobial isolates. It can serve as an identification tool. Differentiation between fast and slow grower on bromothymol blue media. Yeast mannitol agar media incorporated with bromothymol blue was used to distinguish fast growing, which is a acid producing strain, from slow growing agrobacterium, which is a non-acid producing or alkali producing bacterium. In this medium, the fast grower required 48 hours to produce an acidic reaction by turning the color of the medium yellow from green, whereas the slow grower takes more than 96 hours to produce alkaline endpoint with or without change the color of the medium from green to blue, whereas contaminants including agrobacterium will absorb strongly. Next is biochemical characteristics. To confirm whether the isolates were rhizobia or not, they were incubated in different media for each physicochemical test and then incubated depending upon their growth rate at 30 degree centigrade. Catalase activity test. The presence of enzyme catalase in the rhizobial isolates was examined by suspending one loop full of organism in a drop of 3% hydrogen peroxide on a glass slide. This test was performed as per standard procedure. Production of bubble indicate positive result. Citrate utilization test. Citrate utilization by the isolate was observed by the growth on slant of Shimon's citrate agar. The distinct change in color from green to blue referred to as a positive test. Next is establishing the starter culture. Pure rhizobial colony is transferred to the flask containing yeast mannitol agar medium. The flask is kept on a rotary shaker system in a constant temperature of about 28 plus or minus 2 degree centigrade. Pure culture of rhizobium appear within a week. Mass culture of rhizobium. Rhizobium is mass cultured in a large bioreactor to prepare inoculant. Yeast mannitol agar medium or sucrose mannitol medium is used for this purpose. A suitable medium is formulated and filled into the bioreactor after proper sterilization. 1 liter of starter culture for 100 liters of medium is inoculated into the bioreactor, making the carrier based inoculant. A carrier is a neutral medium used to mix with the culture broth for handling it easily. Charcoal peat, lignite, vermiculite, paddy husk or farm yard manure etc. are used as carrier. The carrier holds the broth and allow the slow growth of microbe. Packing and storage. The carrier based inoculant is packed into low density polythene bag for storage and marketing. Usually the biofertilizer pockets are kept in constant room temperature for about a week before storage. During this time, the rhizobia grow by consuming little amount of media present in the carrier. Field application and crop response. Rhizobium inoculant are recommended for various leguminous crop by seed treatment. A 50 gram of cane sugar is dissolved in 500 ml of water and boiled for 15 minutes. 200 gram of gum arabic is added to the boiling sugar solution and stirred well to dissolve it. Seeds are added to the slurry, mixed well by hand. To this solution, rhizobium cells of about 10 to the power of 6 are added and they get absorbed on each and every seed. The sticky solution so formed is cooled at this time. The seeds of legume dried by spreading them on a polythene sheet in shade. The seeds are shown in the main field. Crop response. The seed inoculation of the proper rhizobium strain increase yield and growth of many legumes. Rhizobium usually increase the yield of the legume up to 10 to 35%. Crop rotation of rhizobium inoculated legume with cereals increase the yield of the subsequent cereal crop. Now, what are the advantages of these biofertilizers? Biofertilizers are cost effective, they are eco-friendly, increase crop yield by 20 to 30%, improve soil texture and water holding capacity and restore natural soil fertility, add nutrients to soil and make nutrients available to crop, supplement of fertilizer, replace chemical nitrogen and phosphorus by 25%.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.